Hello friends, welcome to this tutorial on data objects. Since we are talking about the data mining algorithm and we know that the data mining algorithms are applied on some data sets, okay? So to know the data mining algorithm, you should have to know your data sets, okay? So as you can see, the first point that I refer to here is that the data sets are made up of data objects. So what is a data objects? So as you are aware of the subject called database management system, we know that there are two types of entity. One is your physical entity which have physical existence, or entity which have conceptual existence. So generally a data object represents an entity, okay? So for if you take an example, for in case of sales database, the customer can be an entity, store items can be an entity, these customers and items will refer to as a data objects, okay? In case of medical objects database also, patients or doctors can be the entity as well as the data objects. In case of an university database, the students, professor and courses are the entities, or we can say these are the data objects, okay? So in some books you may find data objects are referred to as samples, instances, data points, objects or tuples. So data objects are, these are the synonyms of data objects, like samples, instances, data points, objects and tuples. So these are the synonyms, okay? Fine. So as you know, in case of an entity, attributes are used to define an entity. So similarly, the data objects are also described by the associating attributes, okay? So we have to know here the types of the attributes that a particular database is containing. So if you remember your database management software, in case of we are representing it as a relational database management system, or it's a tabular format. So generally the rows represents the data points and the column represents the attributes, okay? So now we have learned that in case of data sets consist of data objects which generally represents an entity, and these data objects are described or defined by the associating attributes, okay? Next we will see, to know or to apply any data mining algorithm or to apply any data preprocessing technique to the data set that you are going to use in the data mining algorithm, you should first know the type of the attribute that the database or the data object is containing. So this attribute is referred to as either as dimensions, features, variables. So all these are synonyms. You can refer to them by attribute by either by dimension or by features or by variables. So generally attribute is a data field representing a distinct characteristics or feature of a data object. For example, in case of a customer, the customer ID is a data field which representing the ID of the customer. Name is a data field which representing the name of the customer, okay? And address is a data field which representing the address of a customer, okay? So you should know that there are three types of generally attributes in case of a data object. So what are the different types of attributes that are there? Those are nominal attributes, ordinal attributes, interscaled or ratio scale attributes, okay? In case, generally this nominal attribute and ordinal attribute are known as the categorical attribute or the qualitative attribute, and this interval or ratio scale attributes are known as the quantitative attribute or numeric attribute, okay? So we are going to deal with these three types of attribute: nominal, ordinal or interval or ratio scale. So first we have a look at the nominal attribute, okay? So it is very important that whenever you are going to apply data mining algorithm, and before that, if you are going to apply data preprocessing technique, you should at least know what are the different attribute types that your data object is containing, okay? So first we will see what is nominal attribute. Nominal attribute are also known as categorical attributes, okay? So categorical attributes are also known as the nominal attributes. The values for a nominal attribute are names or the strings that come from a small set of possible names. Okay, for example, hair color can be a nominal attribute whose value can be this: black, blonde, brown, gray, red and white. Then marital status can be another nominal attribute. Okay, then occupation. Okay, so these are the example of nominal. You have to remember one thing which is very important, that for practical storage and processing purpose, the names of a may be numbers. Okay, so I can assign some numbers to the nominal attributes. However, normal processing of numerical operations such as addition, comparison do not make any sense. For example, if I say that black is greater than blonde, or brown is equal to gray, or blonde plus brown, or blonde minus brown, does not make any sense. Okay, so since for processing purpose, though it can be converted to numeric values like numeric any numbers, but you cannot apply the normal arithmetic operation like addition, subtraction, greater than, less than to the values of a nominal attribute. Okay, fine. So these nominal attributes are only useful for comparison of equality and inequality. These are the two symbols that I have given. This is for equality and this is for not equality. Okay, so I can say that black is not equal to blonde, okay, or brown is not equal to gray. Okay, so like this. So you have to remember that the values of a nominal attributes are the names or strings that come from a set of possible names, okay, and they are only useful for comparison of equality and inequality. Okay, so examples of nominal attributes also include gender can be another, then country, the like this. Okay, zip codes means the zip numbers. Okay, the ID numbers. Okay, in those cases we can apply the value either equal, two zip codes are equal or they are not equal. Okay, next we will see the binary attribute, which is a special case of nominal attribute. Okay, a binary attribute is a special type of nominal attribute that has only two possible values or two states, 0 and 1. So normally if we try to give the example, gender, marital status, experimental results can be either success or failure, presence of a word in a document, etc. are represented as binary variable or binary attributes. Okay, so binary attributes can be of two types. One is symmetric binary, another is asymmetric binary. In case of symmetric binary attribute, both outcomes are equally important. So if I say that if that particular person is a male, so that is also important, and say if I say that that particular person is a female, so that value is also important. So both outcomes, whether 0 or 1, are equally important. But in case of asymmetric binary attribute, outcomes are not equally important. Okay, so if I said that the medical test of a particular medical tick, whether positive versus negative, so if I said that that particular person is COVID positive, that outcome is really important. But if that RT-PCR test gives you COVID negative result, so that particular outcome is not important. So here importance is, important values are given more weights. Okay, so that's why it is written that convention is that we assign one to the most important outcome. For example, it's in case that particular person is HIV positive or COVID positive, so I will assign to that value, and to the negative value, if that person is HIV negative or COVID negative, then I will assign the value minus to them. So this is the first attribute that you should know, which is the nominal attribute, and binary attribute is a special case of nominal attribute with two possible outcomes.